Hey, what's up, y'all? This is the Mother's House Podcast, and I am here, Deshaun, joined with my cousin,
Corey. What is up? What's up? What's up? What's going on, everyone out there?
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year. It's a new year. First of the month, wake up. Wake up.
So cash your checks and get up.
Get up.
It's the first of the month.
Wake up.
But it's cold as hell outside.
It is cold outside. So let it snow.
Hey, fuck no, don't let it snow.
Yeah, not in Atlanta and not in Georgia. Because that will shut everything down and that will fuck up our money.
Yeah, I don't feel like that.
Like, straight up, man. Okay, I've been approached by several people today, and everyone is saying, it's cold out here. It's cold. It ain't like it ain't cold. It's cold. It's like 20 degrees in Savannah, Georgia. You know what I mean? That's pretty cold for Savannah, Georgia, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, the highest today was like 30-something, like 34 or something like that. So, that's pretty cold for Savannah. So we outside, and the humidity is different because the humidity is like high here, so it makes you feel even worse. So a customer came up, and they were like, "Yo, talking about the weather, talking about how cold it is." And they were like, "This ain't shit. Y'all think this cold? Wait till you go to New York."
Oh God! Get on my nerves. Who cares?
It's ridiculous.
It's like everything. The North thing, they just, like, I get it, it's colder, but they act like our cold is like nothing. Like, bitch, if you so immune to the cold, why don't you take your ass outside with no clothes on? Shit.
I moved to Savannah, Georgia. I don't know why she called it country, but she don't. And granted, these are a lot of white folks.
But I've been hearing that from black people and white people about how.
Yeah, I hear it from black folks too.
All the northerners in general. Oh, this ain't nothing. Y'all don't know nothing. Like, y'all live in a goddamn igloo up there. Shut the fuck up.
Y'all don't know nothing about shoveling snow and having to shovel snow out of your driveway in three degrees of weather.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You don't know nothing about that. I don't care. It's cold out there right now. And it's cold down here. If you ain't cold, take your ass outside and catch them on yourself.
Right.
I'm not catching. I'd rather stay inside, work, or be at home and working on my podcast. That's what I'd rather do.
My podcast.
Or be with my old lady.
Right.
What'd you rather do?
Yeah, like they... Playing? Yeah, they go outside and play and shit when it's this cold up there.
Yeah, for real. I mean... It's funny, though. It's funny like that because, you know, it's not only just the weather that you get that dynamic from. Because, like, is the South so humble? If people from the South are very humble, I ain't talking about everybody, but you know what I mean? Like, are we still seeing naive in the South? Are we still seeing slow down here in the South?
You know, I think Northerners think that.
I don't know, man, because, granted, I ain't up north. When I was in high school, I'm stuttering. Why I'm stuttering?
Ugh. That's like a song.
That made me wonder sometimes. That made me wonder why it's even going. That is not the word.
It's not. Not at all. The fuck?
Dang, you always messing up somebody's song.
Anyway. You doing, that'd be funny.
I do that often. I hope that's on somebody's door. But man. But anyway, when I was in high school, I used to hang with nothing but the northern kids, you know. I used to walk around with hoodies and Timberland boots.
Yeah, yeah, he thought he was from New York.
Yeah, you know, my mama from Jersey.
His mama from Pula fucking Georgia.
She from Bloomingdale, actually. But she lived in New Jersey, like, up till she was 15. But that's neither here or there. My mama's very Southern.
She live in New Jersey. Hey, she live in New Jersey from 14 to 15.
No, mother told me she was living up there since she was like 3.
No, she wasn't, y'all. He lying.
That's what my grandmother said, and I'm not calling. He calling our grandmother a liar. So
no, I'm not calling our grandma a liar. I'm calling him a liar.
No, he calling our grandmother a liar. I know what I heard.
And now he lying on our grandma. Ain't that wrong, y'all? Why would he do that?
See, he dirty. Ooh, they dirty. Anyway, we bypassing the whole damn point. I'm trying to be. Well, get to the point. Oh man, talking in third person. Oh, Umar Johnson, sad nigga. Well, I was growing up in Atlanta, went to high school with a lot of kids from New York. You know, around the time I was in high school, like my 11th grade, I went to Creekside High School. There were a lot of New Yorkers there. I was used to kicking with them because we liked the same kind of music. They were into Nas, they were into the Dots, Jay-Z, Beefs, and all that during 03 and all that time, right? Damn, I'm showing my age.
Yeah, that was way back before I was even like.
Yeah, that was five.
When
it came out. You was in high school. Talking that shit. And they didn't treat me like that, like, you know, but they would have a disdain. They used to always get to fight with the Georgia boys, basically. All the Georgia boys used to fight the New York kids.
Why?
I have no idea. According to one of the Georgia boys, who he was an ignorant motherfucker, though. he was ignorant. He was like, they think they better than us. And they, you know, they talk down to us. When I used to hang with them, they didn't talk down to nobody. They just was into music and hip-hop and a whole bunch of different other cultural themes. They was like, you know, yeah, they country, but these country girls are fine. So, you know, they was into the girls, you know, just like anybody else. But it was just like, far as when it came to culturally and all that stuff. And this is the thing, this is a misconception about, you know, the South. They think a lot of people from the South are not as woke as people up north. I put them woke in a context because the word is dead and we need to come up with a new wave, new term, you know.
All they going to do is wear that term out and misuse it.
Yeah, just for another word for them to come out and misuse it. You know, I'm on a new wave. You know, new wave of thinking, new wave of training. You know, I'm in a world full of egos and I'm just trying to keep humble. But what the fuck that gotta do with anything?
What does that even mean?
Like, what does that even mean?
The fuck?
The fuck is wrong with this podcast? I don't know what they talking about. Wait, what this gotta do with the weather? It's supposed to be cold outside. What this gotta do with the weather? Anyway, my whole thing is when I think about, like, you know, them looking down on us at Naive, I never got that kind of treatment. Cause mind you, John, I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I don't care how I try to match my voice, I'm country as shit. I'm always gonna be country.
Yep, he sure is, y'all.
I'm pretty country, you know, and I'm proud to be country. You know,
you better be proud. Speaking of Georgia. Speaking of Georgia, the Bulldogs are going to the championship. That just came.
Hey, Georgia Bulldog, red and black. I was watching. I was watching a video, old video, and it was like, you know the video I'm about to talk about, Shawty.
Hmm?
He was like, "Hey, let me speak to Master P."
Oh, hey.
What?
We played that in band.
That shit. I was like, damn. I feel old as fuck. When that song came out, I was like in middle school. And I'm like, holy shit.
Ooh, that. Damn. That song used to ride. Yeah, I'm past Detroit. Past Detroit is a legend.
How the words go,
Shotty?
We're like,
what's up? Big mouth, big talk, big game, teacher pet, taking names.
I'm the big on the charge. We ain't live too far.
My nigga, yeah, fuck man, what you say. Dude, ain't no more playing GA.
Words, y'all. I'm sorry. I always
them words is horrible.
But that shit was jumping, man. I remember I have that song. We was coming back from Pebblebrook. This is when I was in Pebblebrook. My cousin was going to Pebblebrook. This is when Tugger was living up there in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And Tugger was on the football team. Me and Marty went to go pick up Tugger from practice. And we was headed back to Six Flag Drive. We were living on the drive then.
The drive. Come through. Drive. On the drive.
Six Flags Drive. All them dogs. L Dogs. Simpson Road.
Austin.
Nothing but them lacks. All the plays. All the hustlers.
Bitch.
There's a black man handling. Yeah. It didn't get a look like wood. Man, we all over the place. But
follow my every step. I'm there too. I'm coming.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me just get this out. Follow my every step. Look at those that I rep. I'm about to go in depth.
All the players came from far away. Where Afro's and Breeze up in the gangster ride.
In the gangster ride. Nigga, you messing up the word.
I'm pretty sure you are.
I'm a pig today.
That's funny because we can hear snapping.
All day, every day. What the fuck?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm a play.
5, 4, 3, 2. Here comes the one. A new year has begun. Come spark another one. One. All the plays came from far away. I wish they would have played that at the little Jewish wedding I went to yesterday.
They ain't gonna play that shit in a goddamn Jewish wedding.
Like, who goes to a Jewish wedding? Like,
niggas with Jew friends.
Yeah. Niggas with Jewish friends.
They're Jewish people.
I wish my girl Jewish friends pass us some damn money.
They don't like y'all like that.
No, they don't. You the help.
Okay, but for the sake of staying on topic.
Stayed on topic. Yeah.
Right. So,
yeah. So what'd you ask me again?
I don't know, but I'm going to answer it. So I think, so New Yorkers, I guess in Atlanta, it's a lot of different people up here. But in Savannah, right. We didn't have a ton of New Yorkers. We had some New Yorkers. And, They were cool for the most part. But as I came up here, I noticed that it's like New York is like the fastest city, so they think everything's slow.
Right.
And then, you know, our family who live up there, they like to come down here because it seems slow. Especially because then they go to like Savannah and go to like the farm and shit.
And it's a trip. They do think that too. They think Savannah's like Mississippi, and that's another thing. They think Mississippi. A lot of people, not even just New York Northerners, think that about Mississippi. People down south think Mississippi is like way backwoods. You know what I mean? Everybody think Mississippi is backwoods, but it's really not. My only experience being in Mississippi, I did had a racist incident, but you know, I got that same shit in Atlanta, Georgia, Savannah, Georgia, Macon, Georgia. Fort Valley, Georgia.
So it's a Georgia thing, huh?
It's a Southern thing. Racism all over. It's a world. It's a United States thing. Racism everywhere. You'll catch it.
It's a global thing.
I think it died down. So it really should be dead by now. I think it's pretty much dead by now. You still got those people in them pockets, you know, from up north or from the south who think. You know, just think about their fire barrels, or just think about their city, and that's all they know because they never been outside of their city. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and ain't nothing wrong with having pride of where you come from, but you got to keep in mind you don't own these streets, homie. You know what I mean? You don't own these blocks. See, in Atlanta, which is becoming one of the biggest black cities in America, historically, like you talk about the West End has always been historically black. You talk about like over there and where you stay at, East Point, College Park, you know what I mean?
All the South Side.
Cascade, Martin Luther King, Adamsville. That's always been historically black areas. Like black families, and that's the thing about, you know, they trying to gentrify, and they are pushing hard to gentrify. those areas. But, you know, a lot of the older black folks that lived there, been living there for a long time, they not having it. You know what I'm saying? I remember used to go into Cascade, going off of Cascade, and there's a, like, if you go to Cascade, there's a certain point on Cascade where you can see Atlanta skyline. Back in the day, you used to be able to see it.
Yeah, I love Cascade.
And you can't see it now because they got a big ass condo in front of that sky, from the viewpoint on Cascade, where you can't see it no more. And I remember when they built that shit, and I'm like, yo, why the fuck they put this here? You know, and I, you know, from doing research and talking to my because my dad had a best friend. His best friend was basically my uncle, Earl.
I remember Earl.
You ever met Earl?
I didn't meet Earl. I remember Earl.
Yeah, Earl's so cool. He got all the Falcons tickets. Like, but that was my dad's best friend growing up in Macon, Georgia, because that's where they from. But he lived out there on Cascade. We used to go over there a lot. I used to play at Adams Park. That's where we did a little Negro League right there off of, I think it's called Adams. No, it ain't called Adams. What's the name of that damn park? It's a park off of Cascade. I give y'all the name when I do my Atlanta history breakdown on my podcast, my Choreo Thoughts. Check that out. But, you know, like, the history in Atlanta, in the South period, we're pretty rooted, very much rooted into the history, into the racism, into being quote-unquote woke, being quote-unquote conscious of our situation. You know what I'm saying? Because we're dealing with the situation every fucking day. And that's why you see, like, a lot of black people in Atlanta, especially those areas I just mentioned, you know, from Westlake, you know, College Park, Hamilton Road, Simpson Road, East Point, College Park, you know, those areas are predominantly older black class, older black families holding down that fort, you know, not trying to gentrify, not letting, you know, gentrification pushing them out, even though, you know, a lot of people come to those areas because it's very cultural there. You know what I mean?
Right.
And then, you know, so, you know, I don't like the fact that a lot of people will overlook the necessary conscious scene in Atlanta. It's very big. You know, you got people of, you got a lot of different people in different various organizations or different various pockets of
empowerment
all throughout Atlanta.
Well, you know, I think that's all about hip hop and what the media makes Atlanta into lately with the reality TV shows, and a lot of the bigger rappers are from Atlanta, the most popular ones, and they aren't really rapping about conscious stuff. Atlanta has a strong conscious scene, but it's overshadowed by the hip hop and the love of hip hop and the reality.
Yep. I'm just agreeing with you. Yep. I mean, if you look at but you got acts like JID, you got acts like Earth Gang, you got a music scene that's, you know, bubbling. You know, with people with content to give me that real about the real Atlanta. And that's the thing, a lot of people come to Atlanta, just like people go to New York, you know what I'm saying? People go to LA, you know, Los Angeles. They don't really be from the city. You know what I mean? It's like Atlanta is at a place now where you kinda you know who's from the city and who's not from the city.
Right.
Just by having a conversation with them. Like, a lot of people wouldn't know you can see a skyline off of Cascade. Back in the day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you see the Atlanta skyline. Like, literally.
I feel like there's still places on Cascade I can see the skyline.
There's some places still. Like, there's a place, like, you go straight up on, get the name of that road, but it's a road that links you to some Cascade Road all the way up. And you, like, you make a right, you can go all the way up to Adamsville. And there's, like, a little spot right there where you can see Atlanta skyline still. Man, I know about that area, but in Decatur is a very interesting spot too in Atlanta for black communities, because Decatur is like the suburbs, but it's the hood too. You know what I mean?
But Decatur is like an inner city suburb, though. It's not like a out there suburb. It's like a next door neighbor suburb.
Yeah. But it's like a lot of black people, when they got some money, they went to Decatur. You know what I'm saying? A lot of new homes, a lot of new up and coming development is happening over there in Decatur, and a lot of black people flock over there to that side of town, so you got a lot of families living over there, and that's where it's getting built. But when you look at what's going on, like on the East Point where you at, and Cascade, Camerton Road, and all those areas on the west side and southwest side, they're not putting as much development into those areas because a lot of people who live there belong, you know, live there for years. They don't want the development because they don't want nobody to come in and try to change and try to push them out. You dig what I'm saying?
Well, you know, I don't think it's necessarily about them not wanting it. I think it's more so about the developers not wanting to come here. And I think there's just so many other areas in Atlanta where they would make more money.
Well, they feel they can, but a lot of people go to, like Camp Creek, they got a lot of big development off of Camp Creek. Camp Creek needs to have all the shit they got now. You know what I mean? But Camp Creek is right now, it's like the hangout spot. Like a lot of people go through Camp Creek. It's like the midway point from South Atlanta to North Atlanta.
No, it ain't.
Right there at Camp Creek, huh?
Listen, no, it's not.
It kind of is. I have been there in a minute, so you tell me. What's the midway point now? From North Atlanta, from Cobb County, North Cobb County, like Smyrna, you know, North Atlanta to South Atlanta. What's the midway point?
I-20.
And that's by Camp Creek, ain't it?
But you know what? Because this is the thing. You know Atlanta very well. So you're talking about Camp Creek that stretches all the way out to like...
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Fulton Industrial. But I'm talking about the Camp Creek that's near my house where I stay, which is like airport.
Yeah. I ain't talking about that.
But that's where all the people at.
Yeah, no, I ain't talking about that. That ain't the same. But, you know... It's just interesting, a lot of people, they, you know, to say that, you know, like, we're naive in the South, like, that's totally bogus, you know, and, you know, a lot of people from up North moved down here to the South with that kind of mentality, think we're naive, oh, we want to teach these people some new stuff, like, we've been on some shit, you know, we've been doing shit, you know what I mean, right. Down here, we just need to get on one page and try to, you know, build up our communities better instead of infighting, you know, who know what. We it's 2018. We need to, right now, we passed on who knows what in the community. We need to get on who doing what in the community. You know what I mean?
Right. And that's, you know, that's all over, not just north or south or whatever.
West, you know what I'm saying, out there in LA. You know what I mean? Midwest, you know what I'm saying? But
Houston.
Like in Indianapolis, it's cold as fuck. Like they got them too. But people from Indiana or Chicago, they don't really come down here with that kind of mentality.
Yes, the fuck they do.
People from Chicago do?
Yeah, they be like, oh, it ain't cold. Y'all know what cold is. Blah, blah, blah.
Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure. But Chicago get real fucking cold. It's Windy City for a reason. But still at the same time, it's cold out here. It's cold in these streets. So y'all keep warm. Be safe. Happy New Year to each and every one of you. You know what I mean? Deshaun, you want to say anything else? You want to talk about Savannah? Talk about Savannah scene? Talk about what you know about Savannah? What you think is changing in Savannah? What
haven't
changed in Savannah?
I think it's just what's happening all over with the building up of the in-towns and the different cities that's happening, the gentrification. And, you know, I think it's something that's not, you know, exclusive to Savannah. It's happening all over the country. As they say, white people want their cities back. But other than that, I'm good.
We good. Well, let's close it on out. I'm going to just say to you guys, you know, thank y'all for listening to the podcast. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and comment on the bottom. We ain't really talking about nothing. We just talking, just shooting the shit. But at the same time, we saying some real shit, too. what y'all think about the gentrification in Atlanta, in other cities?
Where you know, I thought we were talking about weather.
Say that again?
I thought we were talking about weather.
We were. It went to gentrification, so. Yeah. That's what happens when you have interesting conversations. You start off talking about the weather. That's usually what happens when people talk about the weather. They don't really talk about the fucking weather. They end up talking about something totally different. You notice that?
Hell yeah.
A lot of times people ask you about the weather, they really trying to bullshit you on something.
You're trying to start conversation.
Yeah, so... But at the same time, they just really trying to find a conversation just to have a conversation.
Right.
You know. But our conversation turned to gentrification and talking about the development of Atlanta. You know? A city that I hold dear, because that's where I'm birthed, that's where I'm born at. You know? Nigga, you were born in Cotton County.
That's Atlanta.
Get off my phone. It's still Atlanta. Okay, shit. But yeah, tell us what y'all think about gentrification and tell us what's going on in your city. You know what I'm saying? Well, tell us what's going on in your city. If you think gentrification is becoming a big thing, you know, a big problem in 2018, and how we can combat it. Like I said, a lot of older people are holding on to those homes in Atlanta, and they're trying to hold on to them. But don't get twisted. They are trying to push them out. So, you know, we just got to hold firm and stand strong on our property and start owning more property in our communities, you know?
Right. But other than that, y'all, make sure y'all follow us at Mother Talks Podcast.
We can't do that.
Oh, okay. Sorry, y'all. Well, I guess we can't do that.
Sorry. Well, baby Jesus said we can't do it.
Bye.
Peace out. I don't know. Some white lady said it. What white lady? Amy Schumer.
Bye, y'all.
Thank y'all for listening, man. Catch y'all on the flip side.